Hello everyone, this is Tao Ken Yu from Notchback. Okay, over here I have a sinew. And is this a sinew?
Alright, do check out my hobby arena by Notchback where you can filter and find most of the ready-to-fly quads to do side-to-side comparison. This is definitely one of the best places where you can find inspiration for your build by looking at what FPV companies are building. Link to my site is in the description right below. Without further ado, back to my video.
Alright, so sinew. So what is sinew? There's a lot of debate ongoing, especially in the Facebook group, Sinewoopers, right? That's the most popular community that you can find on the internet. Okay, so this is a classic sinew. Is this a sinew? There's always a constant debate. So let's first of all, I'm going to give a lot of credit. Okay, so credit is to NERC FPV. NERC FPV is the one who coined the term Sini Whooping, and everyone call this Sini Whoop. And he actually worked with St. John, Andy Shen from St. John's, and they come out with the frame called Squirt V2. After working with NERC FPV, they come out with Squirt V2. So, and after that, right, a lot of people based on Squirt V2 design, they will call it as Sini Whoop. But like this kind of build, does it really call a sinew? I actually personally want to debate that this is actually also can be considered as sinew. First of all, right, sinew, what my definition of sinew, right, is actually a mega version of tiny wood. So you know tiny wood, right, the small one. I should bring it, never mind. Tiny wood, right, they are actually propeller guard. So a lot of debates, right, for people, right, they say sinew in order for this quadcopter to be considered as sinew, right, it must have ducts. Okay, but personally I disagree. My definition of sinew pin is it must be able to strong enough to lift up a GoPro camera, like, yeah, as mostly is action camera like GoPro, or for me I'm using DJI or small action. So it's able strong enough to lift it up, the GoPro, with an action camera, and it's safe to fly around people. So for this, you see there's there's ducts, there's actually bumpers. So when it hits someone, right, it doesn't hurt anyone. So it doesn't injure anyone or any object. And for this build, right, inspired from Worms Whoop. Okay, personally, first of all, I actually do a lot of research. I go to Stan FPV. I saw one of a build that he has, right, the link is right below, the QAV Cine, right, which is a 2.5 inch pusher, exactly, and that is why I'm using his exactly the same motor. Yeah, after that I say, hey, this is quite an interesting build. They also call it Cine. So I also discover that Korea, there's one famous FPV pilot, they call it Wongs. Okay, and he also come out with the he started from Worms Bunker, and after that he also come out with a frame called Worms Whoop, which is almost the same as this, but this one is like a pirated version because I'm a cheapo person. Yeah, this is the most budget build you can find over here for this type of build, right? Okay, so pusher kind. Yeah, so credits goes to many of the people. Okay, I know a lot of people will say, hey, you need to credit. Okay, yeah, I credit to all of them. Okay, so my definition of sinew, yes, they must be able to lift up an action camera, they must be safe to fly around objects and humans. So that's my definition. So the thing is, right, people always say must have ducts. If no ducts, right, they are not sinew. I beg to differ. Okay, the purpose of the ducts is, right, so that it can create enough trust, right, to carry a GoPro. Because, right, this is a, most of the time, sinew is a 3-inch build. Actually, right now, that's 2.5-inch. Okay, how amazing, right? Getting smaller and smaller. So most of the time, 3-inch build, right, do not have enough trust to carry an action camera, or their flight time will be very, very small. So that is why Andy Shen, right, do a lot of research, right? Do a lot of testing to find the optimum duct design, right? So that it create enough trust to carry a 3-inch cord plus with a GoPro on top. So that's the thing about having a duct. But by removing the ducts, right? Okay, so first of all, I would like to say the now you know the advantage of the having a duct. Having ducts, so it's safe, really safe, and have the trust. But the disadvantage, right, is most of the people will say is that because, right, there's not enough airflow, right, when there's strong wind or a bit of wind stronger than like 10 km per hour, not too technical. So basically that when there's wind, right, you will find that it's harder to control. They call it drifting already. Some they call it sailing because it's like a big sail. Ooh, sail left and right. So it's very hard to get a very nice cinematic shot when the weather condition is not in your favor. That's the thing. That's why a lot of some of the senior community, they start chopping off the darts. That's one thing I'm going to test it. Okay, but for this build, right, they just, a lot of people just remove the ducts. So remove the ducts, and people will say, it's not sinew. Come on, guys. My definition, okay, as long as it's safe enough and enough trust to carry a GoPro, that's the most important. So for this, is, you see, so I follow the QAV Cine design and one suit design whereby there's bumper behind. Okay, bumper at the side, but it's not full ducts. Okay, it's only at the corners. So when you hit, you won't injure anyone or damage any properties. Yeah, and there's some airflow in the front and at the side so that wind can pass through. So this design still will have lesser drifting around. So it's easier control. The flight performance is much better, but because there's no ducts, so the flight time, normally I can get around 10 minutes, 8 to 10 minutes with this. Yeah, so with this, right, I can fly around 4 to 5 minutes, which is still not bad. Depends on what kind of footage you want to take. If you want a short and fast outdoor, right, you can do this. And if you want even faster, right, some people also have removed the bumpers away. So completely, they remove the bumpers. Okay, although without the bumpers, it's still safe because there's the carbon fiber frame around here will still protect people from hitting the propeller. And they will 3D bring additional protection over here, like here, without the bumpers. Remove it. Okay, hopefully I have a picture at the corner for you to take a look. Okay, so so that's another kind of design that people have, okay, like that. Wow, so cool, pink, okay, pink power, okay. So so that's another without the foam bumper. Yeah, Wong Su also have this design with the bumper removed. So he there's different way you can do it, and most of the time for this kind of build, right, we build in a pusher kind of way, so it's it's a much cleaner build. Yep. So for me, the flight controller, you can use the standard F4, F7 with Emu Flight. Emu Flight is the best for Sinew. But for me, I decided to use Falco X because I have a spare flight controller from Flight One, which is the Millivolt OSD. And apparently, I enjoy the whole experience using Falco X. The moment you install the firmware Falco X, right, everything can be configured on the OSD. And the thing is, right, for pusher, if you mount your flight controller normally, everything, right, Falco X, right, they will, on the initial startup, you just use the wizard, right, you just put the cord facing down, nose down, and facing up, then pitch right, that kind of thing, roll right, right, to confirm, then, they will know the orientation of the whole quarter. It's very, very, very easy. You should try it out. You should at least have one Falco X in your life to try it out, how fascinating it is. And and after that, right, you can, through the OSD, you can select the direction of the motor so that to ensure you fly correctly. So very fascinating. So that's why I never regret using Falco S for this build. And yeah, and Falco S is really very smooth. I love the flight performance, plus since there's no dark side, there's enough airflow, so the flight performance is very good for this build. However, the flight time is not good. So that's the trade-off that you have when you have this kind of build. So if you are into cinematic FPV, right? Okay, you have a 5-inch, which I don't have. Yeah, but personally, I don't like 2-bit. Okay, yeah. Anyway, I would strongly recommend have a Cinewook of this kind and a Cinewook for this kind, so that you can weigh against, depends on the different situation that you want. Plus, this one you can customize to go even faster by removing the bumper and adding extra protection to the frame like this, right? So, different option for this, and adding bumper will slow down a bit, so you'll have a much more cinematic feeling. Yeah, so these two. So so all the raw footage, with this build, right, is in the description below. Oh, I also upload all the components and parts, right, in the description, also in the description. If you like roto build, I also put in the description in the roto build, okay? But if you want, you click on the affiliate link in the description below. You will help me a lot building more stuff. Anyway, hopefully that's ends off with my debate of the Cinewook and checking out my build. Yeah, and I want to change my camera from Kangaroo to something better, because I really love this build. It's really very powerful. Oh yeah, but and the motor I use is actually from FPV Cycle 2203 3450 KV. Yeah, hopefully I got the KV number correct. Anyway, it's very very strong, so that is why without the ducts, right, it's strong enough to lift up the GoPro. Okay, and the thing, right, is because of the pancake shape, so you can see it's a bit like pancake shape. It's very low, 2.2 and 0.3, very low. So that is why it's very very cooling. So after flying a few pets, right, the motor is still remaining still very very still not hot. Okay, I still can touch it. Woohoo! But for this Cinewook, it gets very hot. So I also strongly recommend this motor, but one thing about this motor is it is very very loud. Yeah, so without the ducts, it's already very loud. Yeah, so another trade-off that you have in your build, man, decision. So just build as many as you can, spend all your money. And oh yeah, so I forgot to talk about the frame. So the frame, right, is the most budget Cinewook frame that you can find, other than Reptile Cloud 149, right? This is another one with the same frame that has the same design like Daitone Taycan or Bumblebee, those iFight Bumblebee. Yeah, so this one they call it the replica, the clone of Daitone Taycan. Yeah, because of the orange darts, all this is almost the same, but it's actually the Alpha RC Cineboy. Yeah, so it's very 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 cheap. So cheap that I can just do any modification and I don't feel the pain in my pocket, you know. So basically the original is like this with the full darts around, and I just build it upside down so that it become a pusher configuration. And then, right, the darts, the frame is so cheap, I just cut the ducts and cut the foam, right? So and I just paste the foam to the remaining ducts, and I can just mount this to my frame, so it become almost like the Wong's Bunker pirated version and a bigger version of the Stan FPV QAV Cine, right? That the same. So so do check out this frame if you want. You support Wong's Wolf frame, that's the original one, or you go and support Stan FPV, which has a smaller build, is a 2.5 inch, using the QAV Cine frame, 2.5 inch frame, and he drilled a hole so that he can mount his 2203 motor. Yeah, so do support links to the to those two builds, to the frame, to the builds, is right below. Support them. I'm actually copy them using my Sharingan technique. And yeah, so basically a very very budget frame, so you can keep breaking it. Yeah, but so far it's very sturdy, So I don't think I will break it. Anyway, hopefully this help on the introduction. Okay, you can check out my description below for more information. And thank you. Do subscribe. Do not click on the ding dong bell because my channel upload a lot of random stuff. Okay, so just give me some subscriber count. Yeah, and like this video if you like the way I debate. Yeah, or comment if you disagree with me. Thanks for watching.